Richard Hunter, MMA broadcaster with Armin in the Vac, 104.5 The Team, is Phone Booth Fighting podcast. You can find on Twitter at Phone Booth Fight. Richard, can you put in your own words the level of upset the Ronda Rousey loss was on Saturday night?
Yeah, guys. I mean, it's quite simply, it's the greatest upset in MMA history. It was the MMA equivalent to Buster Douglas beating Mike Tyson, except in this case, Holly Holm was a much more accomplished boxer on the feminine side of the sport than Buster Douglas was. But nonetheless, in terms of an upset, in terms of what oddsmakers thought would happen as opposed to what ended up happening in reality, the greatest upset in the history of the sport.
I guess that's my question. Like, I know odds-wise it is, but in reality, should it have been considered the greatest upset?
Yeah, I think it should, because you saw a champion, someone who had never been defeated, somebody who had only been out of the first round once and had never lost a round ever in her career. You saw her not only beaten, not only caught, but decimated. I mean, from beginning to end, that was a deconstruction of Ronda Rousey. So it's not like we can even look at it and say, well, she made a mistake. There was a lucky punch, or there was a controversial outcome on the judges' scorecards. Could have gone either way. You know, there were two defeats in that fight. Before she lost the fight, she lost the first round of her career. I could even argue there were three defeats, because for the first time, she attempted to execute a judo toss on her opponent, which is her main discipline, and Holly Holm stuffed it, rejected it. And so I think before the actual defeat, Ronda Rousey was realizing minute by minute and second by second that she was up against a challenge the likes of which she had never faced before.
MMA analyst Richard Hunter on Twitter at Richard Hunter with Armin and Levac on 104.5 The Team. Richard, how much do you feel like Ronda Rousey overlooked Holly Holm?
I don't know that she personally overlooked her, but I'll tell you this. There was turmoil going on in the Ronda Rousey camp behind the scenes, the likes of which had never happened before with her. So and it was kind of a perfect storm, a trifecta. It was first started by her mother. Ronda Rousey's mother is a very smart woman. She's a legit PhD. She's also a former women's world judo champion herself, and the woman who really initially trained Ronda Rousey to be a judo Olympian. She gave an interview about 3 or 4 weeks ago in which she soundly criticized Ronda Rousey's head coach, Edmund Tavurdian. Tavurdian is the Armenian guy that you always see in Ronda Rousey's corner. He has a gym in Glendale. He, up to the point that Ronda Rousey became famous, had never had another high-profile fighter. He's since had a few more that fight in the UFC. But Anne-Marie DeMars, who's Ronda Rousey's mother, seemingly out of nowhere, gave an interview, said that Edmund Tavurdian was not only a terrible coach, but he was terrible in the way that he treated people, that Ronda Rousey's doing a great disservice directing people to go to that gym, and that Edmund Tavurdian hit the lottery when Ronda Rousey walked into his gym, and his coaching has nothing to do with Ronda's success. That was the first thing. The second thing, about 2 weeks ago, is it was revealed that Edmund Tavurdian, back in July, had filed for bankruptcy. That happens, but interestingly enough, in the court documents, he claimed that for the last 2 years, he had not made any income. Now, if that were true, that would mean that Ronda Rousey was not paying him. And so that raised a lot of eyebrows in terms of, was he being truthful on those documents? Certainly something that would cause a distraction for him and then probably a trickle-down effect to her. And finally, the third prong in this trifecta is, for the first time, Ronda Rousey has publicly acknowledged having a boyfriend. She's dating UFC heavyweight contender Travis Brown. And Travis is the one who publicly revealed that relationship. He gave an interview saying to the effect of, she's my woman and I'm her man, and we're together. And that may not have sat well with Ronda, because she's a notoriously private person who likes to keep all of that stuff behind the scenes. So Ronda's focus in and of herself, not sure, but certainly the people around her had lots of distractions, and I've got to think that had a lot to do with Ronda's mindset going into this fight. And I'll tell you this, guys, I think that looking ahead over the next couple of months, we're going to see some changes involving some or all of those folks in her life and in her training camp.
Richard Hunter, MMA broadcaster, analyst, at Richard Hunter on Twitter with Armin and Levack, 104.5 The Team.
Richard, will Ronda Rowdy Rousey ever be the icon of the sport again? Is she basically done, or does she just come back and dominate again?
Well, she's definitely not done. We're going to see a rematch. I think, in all likelihood, what happens is UFC 200 is a big event that's scheduled for July here in Las Vegas. In fact, it's going to be the grand opening event for the new Las Vegas event center that they're building here. And that's going to be a huge card. And I think, barring any injury to anyone, that Holly Holm versus Ronda Rousey, the rematch, takes place for the main event for that card. So, yeah, no, she can absolutely come back. And she's, you know, she's got such a cachet built up that she will still, I think, be an odds-on favorite to beat anyone not named Holly Holm. And she may go into that rematch as a favorite again. But that being said, she is now human. She is now fallible. And as we all know, whenever on a rare occasion somebody like this does emerge in athletics that is perceived to be superhuman, once they're proven to be fallible, they've got a whole new set of challenges and obstacles that the average athlete just doesn't face.
Richard Hunter with Armin and Levack, 104.5 The Team. Make sure to check out his Phone Booth Fighting podcast, available on iTunes, and at Richard Hunter on Twitter. Phone Booth Fighting podcast includes every single day analysts like Richard Hunter, along with Frank Mir and Ricky Lundell. Richard, ironically as well, you are also known for being the individual, now known for the individual, that found Lamar Odom and called 911 on that day at Dennis Hoff's ranch. What's the one memory out of that you'll carry with you the rest of your life?
It will probably be, you know, the image of his face. I mean, I can really still see it. When I got into the room and he was on his back and I got up on the bed to flip him over on his side, and the vomit and all that sort of stuff with the blood was coming out of him, it was chilling. I mean, it's something that I'll never ever forget. And you know, I hope that at some point I'm going to have a chance to talk to him about that, because you know, I had this moment with this person that I'll never forget for the rest of my life. And, but only between the two of us, only one of us was there. You know, he was unconscious. So I really hope I have an opportunity to tell him at some point, you know, how much that affected me, and how I hope that he never gets himself in a situation like that again, because it really was, one of the scariest moments of my life. But yeah, I would just say seeing his face, you know, and wondering, is this, you know, as I'm holding this guy up, is this guy dying right in front of me? And obviously for a length of time there, we all thought that might very well be the case.
Richard, how have you not had that opportunity yet to talk to Lamar Odom?
Well, I think that I'm not sure how much for right now he remembers about what happened. My understanding is he's still sort of having to learn to speak again and to walk again and things like that. I mean, obviously he's going to live, which is a good thing for him, but I think he's still trying to get a lot of his faculties and his mechanics about him again. So I would imagine at some point we would have an opportunity to have that conversation. And I tell you, I don't know if he'll ever fully realize how much of an impact he had on my life that day, but it's definitely something that's going to be with me forever.
Well, Richard Hunter of the Phone Booth Fighting podcast, available on iTunes. Hit him up on Twitter and Instagram as well, at Richard Hunter. Richard, good time talking to you, man. Thanks for your time today. Really appreciate it.
Yeah, no problem. And keep an eye on this Ronda Rousey situation. I really think, guys, that the next couple of months we're going to see some changes going on with her and her camp, and there'll be a lot more to talk about.